So what is the takeaway points for today's class? We'll see that first. So we are going to gain the awareness of one's mental state at this situation, that is COVID-19 pandemic situation. We need to know how it is affecting your mental state. Next is to know the importance of mental health, because we are all talking about physical health, but the other side of the coin is mental health, which is much forgotten. So it's very important to focus on that as well. And we need to watch out the symptoms of the distress. So that is the red flags again. So we need to watch out, only then we can cater to those distress signs. Next is to understand the coping mechanisms, whatever you are using, whether it is an adaptive or a maladaptive one, and to check, have a check on that. And next is to adapt to the current situation, that is the COVID-19 pandemic situation, which is prevailing and affected the lives of every human here. So we're going to see how do we adapt to such situation. And important of developing the resilience at this very difficult juncture in all our lives. So we'll see more on resilience in the topic. That is a major thing. And the first thing is to know about a little bit on mental health. So whenever we say like there is a physical problem, or let's say in this scenario is a COVID-19 illness, somebody has acquired that illness, what we say is, okay, immediately you have to be hospitalized. So you feel like dying, so immediately you got to be rushed to the hospital. But then in case of mental illness, to name a few like anxiety, depression, or obsessive compulsive disorder, or any many to name. So for in those cases, what is the major advice we receive is just try and remember a lot of people can have it a lot worse. So just come, give a smile, talk to us, hang out, you'll be fine. This is the kind of advice we generally give to people who are having mentally ill condition. But the situation is same as a physical illness. They also need psychiatrist or psychologist attention immediately. So that is very important to know, because both of them affect each other. So we say, first of all, what is mental health? And at this juncture of our life, COVID-19 pandemic, how it is going to affect our mental health as well. So the definition given by World Health Organization regarding mental health is it's a complete state of physical, mental, and social well-being. It's not the, just the merely absence of disease. So I'm not having diabetes, I'm not having blood pressure. We can't just say that I'm healthy. You need to enjoy a physical, mental, as well as a social well-being to call yourself a healthy person. Next is mental health includes our emotional, psychological, and social well-being. It also affects our the way we think, feel, and act. Every day, our life is actually affected by the mental health we enjoy. And at this situation in our life, it is going to have a lot of negative impact on our mental health as well. So we need to really nourish our mental health at this juncture. Next is, it also determines how we handle stress, relate to others, and make choices. So here I would like to tell about the importance of the mental health, how it is going to affect our life in a positive way as well. So mental health, the positive mental health allows us to realize our full potential. Probably we are capable of much more than what we are doing right now. So when we have a right mental health, we can realize its full potential. And next is to have healthy relationship. Even to have a healthy relationship, mental health helps. And avoidance of crime and victimization, because most of the mental disorders brings us to the clutches of law as well. So it avoids us. And because once you know, like when we get more angry also, sometimes homicides can happen. So emotional, the lack of emotional control can lead us to the legal issues as well. So positive mental health can avoid us from those things. Next is make good life choices. For example, eating healthy and sleeping on time, all these things mentally affected people cannot do. Because of that, that will have an impact on their physical health. So making good life choices is possible only a person who enjoys good, positive mental health. And it enables us to cope with the stresses of life. And at this juncture in our life, the COVID-19 pandemic, all of us are facing, but we could see the differences in how people respond to the situation right now. There are people who, you know, take it in a, we couldn't say it's not a positive situation, obviously, but there are people who are coping well, way well compared to people who are not coping well at all. So this mental health also helps us to cope with the stresses, whatever the stresses we are going to face in our life. And also it helps us to work productively and live happily. And obviously it maintains our physical and well-being. So our mental health, when it deteriorates, it has got an immediate impact on our physical health. For example, we are like forced with too many stresses in our life right now. As seafarers, you may be facing a lot of stress right now because of this COVID-19. And even before that also, we have been facing a lot of stresses. But then this stress is even more worst because this is very uncertain. So, and it is completely not in our control. These two factors are making us to face this stressful situation even more difficult. So, this is going to have an impact on our immune system as well. So, when our immune system is compromised, we can have some, when it compromises, any kind of diseases can immediately have an impact on our health. So, it is very important to keep our stress under check. So, we'll see that how in this program. And make meaningful contributions to our communities. And the whole purpose of a human life is to contribute back to the society. So only when you enjoy a positive mental health, we can indulge in these things as well. So now we see how what stress is, first of all. Because a lot of us actually experience and use the term stress obviously and often in our everyday life. But then we don't understand what exactly is stress. So we need to understand some scientific background about what stress is. So here, I would like to talk about stress and performance, that is the Erck's dots and law, just to understand the concept, very easy concept this is. So whenever there is a stressful situation, so in this topic, we are going to particularly talk about COVID-19 stress. So here, when we heard about this situation, which is coming up, initially what happened is people were like in a denial stage. It's not going to affect me or it's not going to come to India or Tamil Nadu and I'm fine. These are the denial stages people were in. So they were not actually stressed because so much of stress has made us to be in a shock situation where we went to denial. So when our stress is too low, what happens is we don't resort to any safety mechanisms, that is hand washing rituals or taking care of hygiene and all that we don't do generally. So what happens is when the stress should not be less also. At the same time, the stress should not be too high also. What happens when our stress is too high is it's going to affect our physical and mental health as well. So we need to moderate our stress levels. But again, it is dangerous to have low stress. That is why media is pumping in a lot of messages to keep our fear intact so that we just like that don't roam out in the roads and get ourselves more, more into the capacity of carrying the disease. So here, this explains that stress is fine, but then only in moderate dosages, not a very low level, but also high level. So now, stressful factors. Now, as a participant, you also can give us what are the sources of stress you're facing in your life as a seafarer. So even before this COVID-19 condition, as I told you, this particular profession itself is a very nice profession, but also a fact which we cannot deny, it's a stressful profession as well. So we could say that there are a lot of sources of stresses like keeping you away from family, loneliness, and the loved ones are away from you, and many other things which are keeping your stress levels too high. So adding to that, now there is one more factor, COVID-19, and because of that, it has led to a lot of insecurities in everybody's lives. People are thinking so negatively about their jobs and whether it will be secure or when I'm going to back to ship. And they are so bored, so depressed. A lot of mixed emotions are facing the lives of seafarers right now. So I could say these are some of the sources of stress. And during the question answer session, you can be more specific on what are the sources which you want me to address also. And I want to explain the sources of stress and the stress phenomena with a bucket analogy, which will be easy to catch on. So just let's imagine a bucket as a stress. So this is our capacity and the vulnerability factor, we could say, the size of the bucket. So each of us will have a different size of bucket that depends on our genes, personality, and our life experiences. So water in the form of sources of stress keep filling this bucket. For example, the interpersonal stress, intrapersonal stress, and environmental stress, and added to that COVID-19 stress. When everything is falling into this bucket as a water, it may overflow at some point of time. So what happens is we need to have something called as coping mechanisms. That's like a tap you can see in the bucket. We have to put a hole in the bucket so that we have to drain the excess water. And when we are not resorting to such coping techniques, then we may succumb to stress. And it can have a different impact on our body and mind. So with this understanding, we'll move on to the next slide. That is, we are going to see what are the impact or the warning signs of stress. It is very important to know these red flags because in my experience, many clients and when I go to workshops also, many people find out that they are stressed only after 1 or 2 years of being succumbed to stress. So by the time it is too late, so it is very important that we know the warning signs of stress, so that as soon as we pick up these signals, we can immediately seek help or do some, you know, activate our coping mechanisms to keep our body and mind healthy. So let's see one by one. So first is the cognitive symptoms. So let me explain about what is cognitive symptoms. It is about your, your thinking, memory, all these are your executive functioning in the frontal lobe of the brain, which is very important for our productivity, which will be affected. So I can explain this with a small example. For example, when you're getting so, you know, you're so much of urgency is there, you have to get ready and go to work, and you'll be just searching for your car key or a bike key, and it'll be just in front of you. But then you won't be able to see that. This goes to show even a simple stress can have an impact on our cognitive symptom, that you're not even able to see it, even if it is front of you. Imagine what an acute and a very strong stress can do to our cognitive symptoms. So that is, we can develop memory problems, we have difficulty to concentrate, our judgment will be very bad, and we can only see the negatives. So whenever we are stressed, our thinking will be most of the times negative. It's very hard to find any positive thoughts in us. And by that itself, we can figure out that we are too stressed. And a lot of racing thoughts and constant worrying. So these will be the cognitive symptoms. What are the emotional symptoms? So emotional symptom, as the name goes itself, which talks about a lot of negative emotions and maladaptive emotions like moodiness, too much of irritability. Even if a family member calls you for some help, you'll be like short-tempered and irritable and agitated and feeling overwhelmed. Even if 1 or 2 job comes up, you feel like overwhelmed, like your bucket is already full and starting to overflow. So you have this kind of emotional symptoms, depressed, loneliness, and physical symptoms. And it's surprising to know that stress and mental illness can have an impact on your body as well. So it can mimic the symptom of physical illness as well. For example, people can start getting aches and pains, diarrhea or constipation. And you must have heard of a syndrome called irritable bowel syndrome. Even that is because of the stress. And next is nausea or dizziness and vomiting sensation, chest pain. There are many people who are having difficulty to differentiate between the chest pain, which is developed due to panic situations or anxiety, or is it a cardiac issue? So there will be chest pain as well, and loss of sex drive and frequent colds. So you will be very much susceptible to any kind of epidemic or pandemic which is out there. And lastly, the behavioral symptom, which is very important to watch out for. You may tend to eat very less, or too much binging will be there, binge eating. And sleep also will be affected. Your sleep will be too less or will be too heavy. And you will be isolating yourself. You will be alienating yourself from other people. And you will be like wanting to be alone, withdrawing yourself from other people. It's a very important sign. You can even help other people who are experiencing the stress symptoms and get them some help. And procrastinating your responsibilities and using maladaptive mechanisms like alcohol, cigarette or drugs to relax. You would have heard about a lot of people in your own life where people resort to these kind of things when they're too much stressed. What happens is they immediately go for alcohol or cigarettes or drugs whenever they feel so stressed out. So, and lastly, the nervous habits as well. So please watch for these symptoms. If you or any of your loved ones have the symptoms, it's very important and to understand that they may be quite stressed and they need help. Otherwise, it can have an impact on their mental as well as physical health. Next is how the stress is going to have an impact on your long-term health. Just to give an idea about how a stress, which is a psychological phenomenon, which can have an impact on your health. As shown in this slide, you can see this kind of stress can have an impact on each and every part of your physical system, starting from your neck and ending into your stomach and even, pains, muscle joints, everywhere. All the parts of the body will be compromised. And even it is important to know there will be weight gain, especially the fat around the middle, because purely because of stress. And we call it as lifestyle disorders as well. For example, type 2 diabetes, cardiovascular diseases, these are exclusively caused by stress itself. So at this situation, especially, all of our stress will be too high because of this pandemic situation. So it's very important that we watch out for this and use some very effective coping mechanism, which I'm going to discuss with you shortly. So we saw, we got a good understanding about stress, and now we are going to see what you're going to do about this. Okay. Next is coping. So what is coping? Let's see what is coping. So coping is nothing but a conscious effort to solve your personal and interpersonal problem. And in this scenario, how are you going to cope with this lot of stress which is thrown at you during this pandemic situation? How are you going to seek to master, minimize, or tolerate your stress or the conflict you're facing? And it is a process that is a cognitive and behavioral efforts to manage the upraised stressors. Okay, so I will explain this through a bucket analogy. Even if you don't understand the previous slide, I'll just explain through this bucket analogy, which will be easy to understand. As I told you earlier, this bucket is full of stress, with a lot of stresses, whatever stress you face in your life. And the size of the bucket, again, depends on your genes and personality. And now, the coping strategy is nothing but the holes we put it in the bucket to drain it. If you don't drain it using the right coping mechanism, it's going to overflow and have an impact on your physical and mental health. So this is the bucket analogy. With this understanding, we'll see what you do when you're stressed. So I want the participants to reflect on a moment, for a moment, and think what you generally do whenever you're stressed. Stress can be from any sources, like intrapersonal stresses or stresses by the environment or a COVID-19 stress. So what you generally indulge in when you're so stressed, just give it a moment and think about it. I hope you would have thought about it. Now, let's see here some of the behaviors generally people do when they are stressed. Maybe listening to music, was there in your head, or playing with pets, screaming into a pillow, taking a bath, sleep, paint, pray, cook, play an instrument, hit a punching bag, use photography, yoga, walk, gymming, writing poem, talk to a friend, watch movie, play video games, or turn to social media. As most of us are doing now, turning to social media, most of the times we are like inseparable from the social media, what we are using, like Insta or Facebook or whatever, YouTube it can be. And shopping, probably it's not possible right now. So these are some of the behavior we indulge in, but these behaviors can be positive as well as negative. So I just want you to think about our coping strategy, what we use. Okay, so what we saw so far is the behavioral aspect of what you do. Now, how about your thinking? So a lot of researchers in psychology, they've proven that whenever we are stressed, we automatically resort to something called as negative automatic thoughts or NACs. That means your brain automatically goes into the pattern of thinking negatively. So especially in this COVID-19 situation, our thoughts will be completely negative. Like, you know, what if I acquire the disorder myself, or what if somebody in my family is going to get the disorder, or what if I go to the hospital and there is no ventilator, and what can go wrong? Like, you know, even it's very difficult, I'm very afraid to even touch my door after my maid has come. So all this kind of negative thoughts will be always, rumination will be there. So what happens when we are into so much of negative thinking, it puts it under a lot of negative emotions. So which will be very overwhelming for us to manage. So here, they say that a lot of cognitive distortion we resort to. So for example, I have come up with one distortion for you to understand is catastrophizing. For example, what if things aren't as bad as I make them out to be? One example is about this COVID-19 is probably you may think that, what if I'm going to get this? I'm having a cough. What if it is only coronavirus infection? Maybe you're catastrophizing. It is not so. So you're overthinking, and all that is because of the cognitive distortion and because of the fear factor you have. So the tendency to blow certain situations out of proportion can be one of the cognitive distortions. Like this, we have a lot of other negative thinking patterns which will put us into a lot of stress, which is not needed at all. What is needed, we see. Okay. So just think for a moment, is there any of your coping mechanism helping you at this situation? Helping you in the situation means, is it helping you to stay positive, healthy, or is it hurting you? If it is helping you, probably you are using an adaptive coping mechanism. If it is not helping you, that means you are not using the right coping mechanism. Okay, so as this I already told you to reflect on your usual coping habits, and how effective are the coping strategy to in the past? Did they reduce or eliminate the stress? For example, let's say one of the participants says that, ma'am, I've listened to the music and I was like, you know, going for a walk So I'm sure that these two habits would have actually reduced or eliminated the source of stress. Whereas if the participant or anyone might have this kind of thinking in mind, that is, I resorted to alcoholism, or I want to suppress my emotion, or I want to eat a lot. These kind of coping mechanisms may probably lead you into a problematic situation. It can create the situation more worse. And lastly, which of the coping mechanisms did you use in the past but no longer using? So viewers, please think about coping techniques which were helping you earlier in your life, very much helping you earlier in your life, but right now you forgot that particular coping mechanism. Okay, you can think of that and start using if it was really helpful. Okay, so for making it more clear, I will just tell you what are the coping mechanisms. I'll name few. Okay, now I've listed here adaptive coping as well as maladaptive coping. I'll just explain the concepts quickly. Adaptive coping means which are the coping factors which helps us to, get out of the situation and keeps us positive. For example, at this COVID-19 situation, things are out of control. So we can only resort to emotion-focused coping and not problem-focused coping. So what we can do is minimize the source of stress. Now we have to distract ourselves and restructure our thinking process. All this I'll explain in the upcoming slides and seek some support. But what you should watch out for is, am I using some maladaptive coping? And make sure that you don't use it in the future. For example, are you avoiding your emotions? Are you suppressing your emotion? Probably you're actually having fear. Okay, you're having fear or depressed feeling, but then you're saying that no problem, I'm fine and all that. But then it can have an impact on your health. So make sure you're not doing it. Or are you indulging in too much of eating or less eating? Or you're going for a binge eating? Okay. Or are you sleeping too much? Okay, these are some of the things which you should keep in mind. And rumination, thinking about it over and over again. So this is again a maladaptive coping, or getting more angry, or giving up, resigning. Okay, everything is in God's hand. I can't do anything. Let me give it up. So this kind of coping, it is all too dangerous. So this is like suppressing ourselves. And also check for your other habits, which is increasing by now, like smoking, drinking, or drug. Whatever it may be, if it is increasing, again, it can be a sign of stress and that you are using maladaptive coping mechanisms. Okay. So at this juncture, only this particular prayer can help us. That is, God grant me the serenity to accept the things I cannot change, courage to change the things I can, and wisdom to know the difference. This concept is a little difficult to understand, but once you understand, this is the one word answer for complete stress management, especially at this situation. That is, we are praying the God to give us the serenity to accept the things we cannot change. For example, this COVID-19 situation, as I already told you, we cannot change. We cannot do anything about it. It's completely out of our control. So here the solution is given that we need to accept it. Only when you accept it, solutions will follow. And courage to think, change the things I can. Whatever is in my control, let me change it. And God, please give me the wisdom to know the difference between the two. And there are a lot of people struggling to find out the difference between what they can change and what they cannot change. Struggling to change the people, change the situation. And why can't they find out vaccine for this COVID-19 and what these people are doing? All the things are not going to help. I know as a human being, we can't just like that flip the button and say, now everything is changed and I know I can accept the situation. We are not yogis. But our mind will come to that acceptance stage slowly. Probably it will take some months, and by the time now itself we have been, already 1 hour, 1.5 months is over, and we would have come to an acceptance stage gradually. If not, also we need to probably come to that stage quickly. And how to do that also, I'll explain the coming slides. And this is a very nice quote to talk about the situation. When you can't control what's happening, challenge yourself to control how to respond to what's happening. That is, that's where your power is. When we now the situation is that we cannot control whatever is happening around you. We cannot even change to the government rules and say I will go out and work, or I don't know what the shipping situation is going to be. I'm going to change the policies, rules. Nothing is in our hand. But one thing is in your control: how to respond to what's happening. So that is where our power is. So that response and free will is still with you. The choice is still in you. And what to focus on, we'll see in the next slide. Now, how to focus on things which is in your control even now. First one is importance to self-care. We need to, this is a time that we have a lot of time right now to take care of ourselves and self-care, which is very important. And I'll explain more of self-care in other slides. Next is wash your hands only for 20 seconds. There are people who are continuously going for a washing regime, which is not needed. So just for 20 seconds, it's enough. And limit COVID-19 news. Check for the authenticity. So check whether it is from the government sides or it is from the WHO, that is World Health Organization, which has given a recommendation, or a Ministry of Health and Family, whether they have given the recommendation. Please only believe such news. Other news through WhatsApp and other people, if you hear, please stay away from such news, which will minimize your stress to a large extent. Next is, it is not necessary to be obsessive about cleanliness. There are people who have already got some mental health problem like obsessive compulsive disorder will be indulging them into more of cleaning. Even I heard from one of my clients is taking bath for more than 5 to 6 times a day, it seems. So at this situation, your existing mental health condition will again, will increase. So there is again a problem of your mental health condition increasing and a new mental health problem coming up as well. So the future is about really nurturing your mental health. So next is, we need to acknowledge our emotion. It's completely normal to feel fearful, completely normal to feel anxious and worried. Every human being will have this emotion, and it's not that only one of you is feeling. Everybody would feel, and it's too much. It's okay to feel such things and accept it and let go of it. Next, what we can do is develop the acceptance, and there is nothing going to come out getting angry or blaming. Getting angry over the situation or getting blaming other people is not going to make corona go away. Okay, so we have to just accept it and beware of your negative thoughts. Negative thoughts are the ones which catastrophizes our emotions. So our emotions go out of control once our thoughts become too negative. So it is very important that you keep a check on your thoughts. Very important. So when you are not doing any work, just put a pause button and just look into your mind what it is telling. Is it positive or negative? If it is positive, well and good. If it is telling something negative, then immediately substitute it with a positive thought. Okay. So I'll tell what kind of positive thoughts in the other slides. Next is, now that we cannot do anything about this fearful situation, and plunging yourself into listening to more and more of COVID-19 is going to make your fear out of proportion. So just divert your attention to follow some leisure activities or pursue your hobbies. There are many people who are resorting to their long forgotten hobbies like painting and resorting to board games and having some family fun. So do divert the attention that way. And stay connected with people. Only that physical distance has to be maintained. So we can always stay connected emotionally through a phone call or talking to people and having a Skype talk or whatever it may be. Do stay connected, which is the essence of human life. Very important. And lastly, practice gratitude. So about this gratitude, I will again talk in the other slides. So your priority is only to think of health. A lot of other things, sources of stress is there. I'm not saying it is not there. A lot of the sources of stress may be affecting you. But then our priority should be on the health right now, because we are still in a war-like situation and the war has not stopped. Only after the war has stopped, we need to recover and then rejuvenate. Right now, we are still fighting with the condition. So we have to only think about the health and be a little proactive about other financial stresses or other stresses which a COVID-19 is going to make us face in future. But nothing is going to happen sitting and worrying about it. We need to take some proactive steps regarding it. So now this slide is very important. And I'll just explain very simple way. May not get confused with this slide. See, whenever there is a problem situation which is thrown at any human being, our body will be out of homeostasis. So there will be four kind of people will come to us. That is, there are certain people who will succumb or give up. So there will be people who will give up and then they will be like a failure. So they will give up saying that, okay, let the coronavirus come and hit me. I'm not going to do anything. And they feel dejected. They don't do any proper routine. So all these are the succumbing people. And next is diminished. Their original level of functioning will not be there. They will be having diminished functioning only. So they are also affected people. But the third category is the resilient people who bounce back from the stress and they are very focused, flexible and flowing. And the fourth category is something which we can't think about, is thriving and doing much better than before. So that is something is the greatest thing to achieve. But then at least let's focus on the resilience thing, how we can attain the resilience. So this beautiful quote which I found out is, it is not the strongest of the species that survive, nor the most intelligent, but the ones most resilient and responsive to change can survive this scenario. So we have seen a lot of ice ages and a lot of things have happened in our past. And after all the destructions which has happened, who survived are those organisms which were adapted to the situation. And none of the organisms which are strong, intelligent survived, but those organisms which adapted. So adaptation is the key. So that is where our resilience also comes. The ability to bounce back after disappointment or setbacks or a COVID-19 situation, to be adaptable and flexible and to renew your sense of vitality is called resilience. So resilience, simply put, is like a rubber band. Once you flip it, it comes back. So resilience is the ability to bounce back after this disappointing situation called COVID-19, and how to stay positive, we see, and how to develop the resilience. I will share some positive things with you here. So the question is, do you bend or break? So you can see a tree image here. After so much of storm, there are some trees like bamboo which stays, which will bend so much. But then finally, after the storm stops, it will again come back to its original posture. But there are even strong trees which will be cut off or uprooted completely. So this shows us that adaptability is a very important thing, very important quality which we need to develop, skill which we need to inculcate. Otherwise, we will be broken after the situation. Okay, how do we adapt? This is the first rule for resilience. The first rule for resilience, to develop the resilience in yourself, every human being is capable of developing their resilience. So the first thing is to have self-belief in themselves, oneself. Believe in yourself. Know that there is something inside you that is greater than any obstacles. So there are people who are confident, who may even think that, okay, whatever the uncertainty strikes me, or what are the job insecurity which I'm going to face in life, I still believe in myself. Even if I'm bankrupt, I can come back and start my own thing. So that actually depends on your self-belief. It is very important to have a staunch belief in yourself. That is the self-confidence that we need to improve. And I'm just telling you what are the important points that can improve your resilience. So this 1 hour, we can only talk about these points on how to develop. You can definitely take up from here and start improving yourself. Next is adapt. So as a seafarer, you know that I can't change the situation, direction of the wind, but I can adjust my sails to always reach my destination. Do you have any power over the nature that is changing the direction of the wind, or if there is storm or tsunami? You have no control. But what you can do, what is the control you have? You always have the authority and you have the responsibility, and you can adjust your sails according to the, you know, whatever happens, I can adjust it and then reach my destination accordingly. Maybe it will take more time, but at least that you survive the whole phenomena without succumbing to it is the great answer to it. Okay, so adaptation. We need to learn how to adapt. Those people don't adapt, perish. Next thing is take care of your lifestyle, which is very important, which will keep you very positive at this situation. First thing, do some regular exercise. At least 30 minutes, 4 to 5 days per week. You have to do some cardio, at least walking or jogging or whatever it could be. And next is eating healthy diet and avoiding caffeine and tobacco. So healthy diet, now we are all resorting to healthy diet without much of Swiggy and Uber services and the hotel restaurant services. So this is one positive point, again, because of COVID, and eating the healthy diet and avoiding much of caffeine and tobacco, and Taskmasters and all the alcohol thing is closed now. And so we can resort to all healthy habits, and this is the thing which we can take care of at this juncture. Next is getting enough sleep. Just because time is limited, I know time is unlimited sometimes, even taking care of yourself as well as your children at home, make sure you have some schedule for them and they are going to sleep and having some 6 to 8 hours of sound sleep, which is very important for their immune system as well as for your physical and mental health. Next is healthy pleasure or leisure. You can always take a break and a break from your routine, break from your work from home and all that, and indulge into some healthy pleasures or your leisure and spend some time with your children or grandchildren. Have your own me time where you can think about yourself. Next is you can follow yoga meditation, deep breathing, or any relaxation technique. So it is very important to do at least one of those techniques during this highly stressful situation. Otherwise, it can have an impact on our health. So I don't know how many of you follow yoga. Maybe at the end of the session, you can tell me. Any of these four techniques, try to follow. And the next topic, next important point, which will keep us very, very, very positive, I mean, very resilient, is positive attitude, which changes everything. But it is not very easy. It is a skill to train our brain to see the positive amidst a lot of negatives which is happening. Even I myself prepared a own list about what are the positive things that happened during COVID-19 situation. So negative people or a pessimistic people can come out with 20, 30, even 100 things about whatever negative things, that COVID-19 has given them. True, I'm not denying. But there are also some positive things which are happened and happening in our lives. And our mind has to be trained to look into the positive attitude. Only then it changes the situation, because we have no other excuse than to ponder on the positive things. So, for example, you can even after this session, you can just sit and think or even pen down or a journal. Say, what are the positive things which are happening to me at my situation, life right now? One example I could give you is to spend some more time with my family and stay away from the pollution and stay away from a lot of this traffic and commotions, all these things. And we have to just ponder. We have to develop our train and open it up so that we could see a lot of positive things which are happening even now, which will keep us more positive. So how do we do that? So I've just formulated some affirmations now. So some affirmations which are just got for you. You can just take a look at these affirmations. These affirmations will help you to improve your self-belief as well as help you to sail through a very tough situation right now. Example, saying 50 to 100 times every day to yourself whenever you feel negative, little emotional, fearful, I am safe and secure. All is well. This too shall pass. See, first you should understand all the tough situation never stays forever. It also will pass. Even the positive things will pass. Similarly, negative situation also will never stay forever. It will also pass. So that we have to think of. And about nourishing yourself, we can think about these statements like, when I believe in myself, so do others. And my body heals quickly and easily. Every cell in my body vibrates with energy and health. These affirmations, please choose any one of the affirmations or the statement from this slide and keep telling to yourself 50 to 100 times. You will see a lot of good things happening in your life, because positivity attracts positivity and negativity do attract negativity. And next point is very interesting point, but little difficult to understand. That is, find your purpose. And this is the right time for us to think about our purpose and meaning in life, because we are all on automatic pilot mode. We were children, we studied, and then we went for a work, and then we got married, and then we went for some other work, and still continuing. And as a sailor, you come back home and stay with your family and spend some 6 months time, then again go back and sail. So now that you're not sailing, probably if you're in a break because of this situation, you can think about, what is my bigger purpose in my life? Because the truth is, and I believe so much in it, that all human beings are born with some bigger purpose. So if you ponder upon it and you can really go ahead with that purpose and to give back to the community and society what you really got. So God or nature has sent us with ultimate thing, and without that we can't just like that die. So we need to give back to the community and make our life, whatever soul which has been given to us, very fruitful, and try going behind the purpose. So finding the purpose and meaning is the beautiful thing, and if you do that, you will automatically have some goals in life which will keep our life productive, and we won't feel immediately dejected because of certain setbacks in our life which are temporary. We have a big picture to pursue. And next one, gratitude, which I already said I will visit again. So it is a very important positive virtue, because all our human minds, especially when it is negative, it will trick us to think negative things. Always ponder on things what we don't have in life. For example, oh my God, I lost a very important opportunity. I was about to write this exam and get into the next post in my career. Now it is a great setback. So many things we ponder on like this, and what are the setbacks I have? But do we have some time to ponder on what are the blessings we have in life? At least I'm alive now without any health issues or mental health issues, or I'm having every function of my body, I mean, every part of my body is functioning and I'm able to do something at least. So all these are the positive things. Even if you really train your mind, we can see a lot of good things. So I can tell you one small tip is that by the time you go to bed, you can have a small journal with you besides you during the bedtime where you can write your gratitude diary. I'm grateful for so-and-so things which are happening to my life right now. If you just follow it for 5 to 10 days, you will see a lot of positivity in you and a lot of changes which I can assure you. Because our mind will trick us and never allow us to see the blessings. So we need to try this activity. Only then you will know what it is. So next is, we'll see with the flow. Next thing is the hope. Hope is very, very important at this situation. Because without hope, we'll all be gone now. It's the ability to see the light in spite of being surrounded by darkness. It's like a person carrying the umbrella, saying that, okay, today it's going to rain because I'm praying. So that is the kind of hope we have at this situation. Hoping that there will be a vaccine soon, hoping that there will be a medicine soon for this, hoping that things will be much more better after this, and COVID-19 has taught something to us and our life is getting more, you know, productive and potential oriented after this. So this hope is something which will keep you positive during this warlike situation. And it's very difficult to develop, but then you need to be able to see the positive things and then your hope will improve. So you can see in this PowerPoint, green, small, thing budding out of this very tough rock. This shows that we are, as a human being, also capable of this resilience and we can stay strong during the situation. Next is, please stay connected, as I already told you. Social connection, because we are all human animals, I mean social animals. So we need to stay connected. Can't say that I'm all alone, I'm enjoying. In my own experience, a lot of old people now started to say that, oh my God, I'm afraid because of without of people and I feel lonely. Now I feel like getting connected to people. And this situation has taught us the importance of relationship as well. So that one only will keep our heart and soul very warm, apart from money as well. So we need to be connected socially. This is again a tip for becoming resilient. And lastly, develop your problem-solving skills. Don't see anything as a problem, but as a solution. So we have to put our thinking cap and start seeing solutions in a more creative way, not like a rigid way. Okay, first think about the problem and then we can generate a lot of solutions to it and figure out one solution, which is really good for you. Because at this scenario, if you see everything as a problem, then we'll totally succumb. You see it as, it's a challenge for me. Let me face this challenge. One by one, let me face this and come out of this successfully. Then everything will change. So the difference between a resilient person and a not so resilient person, these important 8 qualities which I shared with you. And I wouldn't say that after the session, you can immediately improve these qualities. But this awareness will help you to slowly develop yourself to ponder upon these points so that you can start developing these skills. And definitely you will emerge very successful in this very tough situation. And I would also wish that you will also come out more triumph. And like I told you, we'll be more like a productive thing also can happen post this COVID-19 situation more than being resilient. So I hope for that to happen. And I thank HIMT, especially our CEO, Mr. Vakil, for giving me this opportunity to address a very important topic at this juncture for all the seafarers. I hope I have done some justice to the topic. And now I welcome the questions from the participants. And I already got one question from Mr. Janaka, which I would like to answer right now. So he said that media is flooding us with a lot of negativity. And what kind of good is it doing to us? As I told you earlier in that graph, okay, normal distribution graph, there are still people who are going out there, going out in the road, especially I would say people in the 20 to 30 age bracket without any fear. Okay, they say that COVID-19 will not affect me. This kind of irrational thinking they are into. So there are always 3 set of people who are like not at all having fear, so-called stupid people, I should say, irrational people. And there are people who are so much afraid. So that is too much of stress. Both are not good. We should be in the moderate. So how do we look into the media right now? So media is also doing some job. As well, always, they will try to be on the limelight by giving all this news for their own commercial and to stay on the limelight as ever. But as a citizen, you have the choice to whether read or accept it. You should use your critical thinking skills to see whether news is right one or a wrong one. As I told you earlier, please believe only news from WHO sites and government websites. never to any WhatsApp forwards or any other media which is telling, like even there are a lot of media which many people thought it is true, a lot of myths. We have to take steam and a lot of things are passing and people, so it is even airborne, all this kind of news. It's only trying to make us more fearful. And as I already told you, we can't control what's happening around us. We can't go, plead the media to play, very responsible role. It will be very good. Even I wish that could happen, the media to play a very responsible role. But then situations again out of our control. So at least we as a human being know how to respond to them by deciding not to really listen or believe such news from fake sources. Please stay away from unauthentic fake sources. That only will keep us under control, our emotions under control.
Yeah, I'm Mahendra Tiwari here. Mm. What my question is that my friends and me, they're on leave since very long time, last 3-4 months. Mm. And actually, we were about to join in March or April. Mm-hmm. But due to this unprecedented situation, mm-hmm. Now nobody is going to join so soon. Mm-hmm. And also our colleague seafarers who are on board, they are on board since very long time. Mm-hmm. Although we want to relieve them, but looking at the present situation, now presently there is no crew change allowed.
Yes.
But we are thinking that even if it is allowed, how are we going to join? How can we just leave our family and go away? Now we both will be in stress.
Yes.
Me, myself and the family over here. So, we can't see that very soon we are going to join. Of course, financially also we are draining. Mm. So, although we are now able to handle the stress, but in next, say, 1 to 2 months, if the situation doesn't improve, so that kind of stress is, going on in our mind. And slowly, it looks like it is piling up.
Mm.
So, how to handle these kind of situations, ma'am?
Okay, sir. Thank you for your question. So here, yeah, this is a similar situation many are facing, right, like you rightly said. So, but then we'll have to wait and see. So 1 or 2 months after that also, this COVID-19 situation is going to prevail. So we can't limit by our time and say by this time or by September, nobody can come up with that particular certainty and say this can happen. So we are still uncertain only. So at this scenario, when the government says, for example, let's say you can still go for sailing. So far, they have not said that. But if the government is coming down and then telling that it's okay, we can be open for sailing and all that, then we can go ahead and make the choice there. Because only then we'll know, because you're also saying that financial thing is draining and all that. But once they say you can be okay for the sailing, you have to follow certain procedures and precautions like social distancing. But it's when it comes to sailing, it's going to be very tough. Only before even you starting to sail, a lot of precautionary actions will be taken. And all of them will be definitely checked and all those things will be definitely taken care of. Only then you will start to sail. So even then, there is a lot of challenges and strain which you are going to see. So whether you are going to prioritize your safety or finance, again, the choice is in your hand. I know both are very important right now in your life. But now the situation is uncertain. Government has not said anything. Definitely, you may not take any steps about even thinking of going and joining. And the regrets will be there. Okay, the right time I want to go and join, this has happened. So the regret will always be there. This is why I'm telling you, we need to be resilient enough, because this is a tough situation and real tough situation. It's not, we are not actually thinking irrationally, it's a real situation. But thinking over it is not going to help us at all in any way. So what we can do is try to change the way we think. The finance situation is always faced by everyone. So 1 or 2 months, whatever resource we have, we need to really plan our finances so that we don't spend much right now. Anyway, we don't have even sources to spend much also right now. All the activities are shut, right? So you'll have to take a priority. First, whether should I go for, should I give more importance to finance right now or to the safety? I would say the situation is faced by me, I would say safety comes first now. So probably, let's say the highest deadline would be in another 3 to 4 months or 6 months also. I would say personally, it is better to wait and take care of your finance, because always a person say that finance is not, there is no limit to the people who are having this financial conditions. Everybody is having a financial problem. So we need to cut down on our expenses and plan accordingly. So I would say please put importance and priority to your safety and your family safety as well. And try to see what are the positive things. Maybe you did not have much time to have a good relationship with your family. As I told you earlier, positive attitude. A lot of positive things which were happening in your life, try to make use of that. Don't always resort yourself to the negative thinking, oh my God, nice opportunity I've lost in my life. More often you think, more often you're going to be dejected and depressed. And there is no use in such thinking also. It's not going to help us come out of the situation only. It is only telling you to make some decision. That's why all these negative thoughts are bothering us. You make a decision, all these negative thoughts will go away from you. But I would suggest that the decision should be about safety right now, because for sailors, that way you will be going to a lot of countries as well. It is not quite safe. The COVID-19 situation is still not under control. So once the safety has come in, then irrational fears can be removed and you can follow the strict procedures as given by the government, also the Seafarer Society, and then follow it and go. Later then, we should not have any irrational fears, thinking that, okay, what if I acquire the disorder, diseases and all. That should not be there. That should not continue after 3-4 months of when COVID-19 has stopped. Some people will resort to such thinking even after COVID-19 situation. That is the wrong thing. But right now, we are having a warlike situation where we have to only think about our health and safety. We don't have time to think about anything else like money, other things and all. Takes a next seat only. That only I would say.
Ma'am, thank you very much for your advice. Also, I wanted to ask one more thing. That what suggestions shall we give to our onboard colleagues during this time? Because they are away from the family, and although they want to sign off, they are on board since very long time,
yes,
but they are unable to sign off. So what suggestions shall we give to them right now?
So what I could say is definitely a lot of mixed emotions will be there in people who are still sailing. Can understand that because the family members are away and all that. So if technology is helping there, ask them to stay connected with their family members, at least to speak once every day. And ask them to ensure their family members that they are safe. That is very important, because even the family members will be under so much of stress because their loved ones is away. And you have to just give them a positive vibe, saying that probably the situation will get over soon. As I said, hope will help us 1 or 2 months and see what can be done. Probably when they are on board and all that, they'll be getting money also for that, since they are sailing now that they are not relieved. So let them see the positive side of the situation. And one best thing keep them positive is to stay connected with the loved ones and ensure them, and stay away from all those negative messages which are spreading across.
Thank you very much, ma'am. I'm sure this is going to be very helpful for me, and surely I'll pass on the words to my friends also. Thank you very much.
Welcome.
Thank you, ma'am. Dr. Chitra, ma'am?
Yeah.
Yeah, the time is up. The last question were asked by, what is the advice to the seafarers who are on board exceeded most day to stay calm and able to focus on job and stay strong till they are relieved and reach home?
Is it the same, similar one?
Yeah, like what she just answered that question now.
Yeah. Yes.
Participants, any other questions for Dr. Chitra?
Ma'am, this is Monisha. Can you hear me?
Yeah, I can hear you.
Yeah, ma'am. I just want to clarify with this maladaptive coping method. I normally use this as my stress, to overcome my stress. I keep on thinking over it, like a rumination, whatever you have explained it.
Okay.
And I feel this method is much more making me comfortable and overcoming the stress much more very easily. Is that good, or should I adapt to some other practice?
Okay, so thank you for the question. And it's obviously not a good method. Probably you developed it as a habit for a long period of time and you're thinking that it helps. Actually, it does not help, because you may think that worrying will help me staying away from the problem or the situation from happening in my life, right? So you would have spent quite a lot of time ruminating, but once you finish ruminating, you could see your energy levels very low and everything, you'd be drained and feeling negative and having a lot of self-doubt after the rumination. Your mind is only tricking you to believe that it's a good method if you don't ruminate and some wrong things are going to happen. But the truth is, nothing wrong is going to happen, and rumination is like ripping the onion. It's not going to help you. It is going to cause you the tears like the onion is giving you. So please stay away from this habit and read more on rumination and what are the impact of worrying, and resort to other healthy coping techniques, which I advise you.
Thank you, ma'am. Thanks for the wonderful session.